have to do in this video. Ugh, gosh.
I'll stop this for the bad bitches only. Baby, you got it, come and put that pussy on me. Up top, stop talking like I'm the homie. Baby, you know I'm surviving to be the homie. You finna run me that pussy when I come back home. And when I eat it, you feel it.
What's poppin', y'all? It's your girl, Easy A, okay? And in this video, as y'all can see by the title, I'm gonna be giving y'all all the information on housing at VCU, all that good stuff, because I've been getting a lot of DMs and questions and confusion about how housing works at VCU, and I'm gonna explain it to y'all. Y'all see I got my I Love VCU shirt, how ironic. And yeah, so if y'all ready for this video, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, share with your homies, y'all already know the drill. And turn on your post notifications so you know every single time I post, like, what is y'all doing? And let's get right into this video. Okay, y'all. How y'all like my hair? Back with the OG bun, but different. Quarantine, but make it cute. Mm-hmm. So, y'all, basically, I'm gonna try to make this as clear as possible. It's kind of hard to explain, kind of not hard to explain, but this is the thing. So at VCU, for housing for freshmen, I think someone told me that the application opens May 1st, and today is April 28th, so I'm gonna get this video out to y'all before May 1st, okay? So basically, for freshmen, there, when I was a freshman in 2018, there was 4 dorm buildings. There was GRC, which was brand new. Like, my class was the first class to stay in GRC. If you guys have not seen my GRC room tour, I stayed in a suite, but my suite was kind of different from the others. I'm gonna tag it right here. Y'all go check that out. And then I did a GRC dorm building tour. Also gonna tag that right here. It's probably on this side, to be honest. Y'all go watch that as well. Okay? Okay. Now, there's GRC. They had Johnson, which is like 17 stories, Brandt, which is like 18 stories or something like that, and Rhodes, which is about around 17 stories, something like that, and GRC, by the way, was 12 stories. So they had those 4 dorms, okay? So as freshmen, those were the 4 options that we had on our housing application. I don't know how it looks now. I don't know what it's been like since then, obviously, because I'm not a freshman. So basically, GRC, if you want to stay in GRC, there are suites and traditionals. Okay, this is where my video comes in handy. You have to go watch the tour because I'm going to try to explain this to the best of my ability. Traditionals are the traditional dorm rooms, 2 people in the room. It's just that simple. 2 people in the room. Y'all don't have a sink in there, and y'all don't have a bathroom in there, of course. So the traditional people, y'all use the community showers. There's 1 on every side on the floor, so 2 on each floor. Then, if you have a suite in GRC, if you have the suite that I had, the reason why my suite was the way it was is because I was the first room on the floor. So when you come off the elevator, you can make a left and go to the rooms down there, or you can make a right and go to the rooms down there. You will make a left off the elevator, and as soon as you open the door, the first room on the right was my room. So because my room was the first room right there, when you open the door, it was a hallway. Okay, it was a hallway. Then you had mine and my roommate's room on the right, and on the left-hand side was my suite mate's room, and then we had our bathroom right there in that same corridor, basically. So the key that we had to our room, all 4 of us had the key to the room, but me and Precious, our key could only open our door to our specific room with inside that door, and then my suite mate's key could only open their room with inside that door, if that makes sense. Watch the video. I'm gonna try to screen record it and put it right here so y'all know what I'm talking about. Then the regular suite rooms, if you're not the first room on the floor, the regular suite rooms, someone had questions about this. This is how it works. You do not choose your suite mates, okay? You choose your roommate. Freshman housing, you do not choose your suite mates. We'll get into upperclassmen housing, okay? For freshmen, you cannot choose your suite mate, but you can choose your roommate. So the person that's staying in the room with you. And the reason for that is because if you have a suite, if you don't have the suite that I had, it's two doors. So my room was one door, had four people's names on the outside. You open it, one room right here, one room right there. Cool. Other suites is two separate doors. So if Caitlin and Madison are roommates and their suite mates are Kensley and Shaquana, there's two doors. Whoever I said, Madison and her roommate, her room will be 501, and then Kenzie and her roommate will be 502. So it's two different doors to get into the room. So when you have your key, you open this door, they'll open that door from the outside, kind of like a regular apartment. You already have the doors right there. You get me. Then y'all have your room, y'all have the sinks in your room. And for those suites, there will be like a sliding door on this side. On the opposite side. So a sliding door on this side, sliding door on this side for the other room. When you slide that door open, that is where your little hallway is. If you remember, I said for my room, as soon as you open the front door, the hallway was right there. For the other suites, you have to walk into your room, and when you move the sliding door, that's where your hallway is, and then your bathroom is in between that hallway. That's how it works. That's why you don't choose your suite mate, because it's two separate doors, two separate rooms. Like, you don't have a key to that person's room. Understood? So that's kind of like how it is. I tried to explain to the best of my ability, like, because I can imagine it in my head, but hopefully that makes sense. Okay, so that's GRC, traditionals and suites. For Johnson has triples. So I'm not sure if Johnson has doubles, which is the regular two people in the room, and it also has triples, so three people in the room. And then Brant is all suites. Brant, you can have a four-person suite or an eight-person suite. A four-person suite is two bedrooms. Y'all open up the door. Y'all have a common area. It's like a little living room, okay? Then you have your room right here. Two people are in that room. There's a door. You open the door. That's where the bathroom is. And then you can open the door from the other side to get to the other person's room. And there's two people in there. That's kind of like how the suite is in GRC, if you didn't have my type of suite, okay? That's how Brent is. So there's a website, VCU Housing. Y'all should make sure you're familiar with it. I'll link in the description box down below. They kind of have tours, virtual tours in there or whatever. And pictures of what everything looks like. So that's a four-person suite. An eight-person suite is the same thing. Y'all go in, you'll have a common room, but it's four bedrooms. So one room, two people in each room, and then two bathrooms, because those two rooms connect and have one bathroom, then the other two rooms connect and have one bathroom. So there will be eight people living within that like little apartment thing. Okay. Rhodes is, oh, by the way, Johnson is co-ed, GRC is co-ed, Brant is co-ed, but everyone in your suite is the same sex. So it will be eight guys in the room, four guys in the room, eight girls in the room, four girls in the room. Okay. Rhodes is, every floor is the same sex. So all males on one floor, all females on one floor. They have doubles. Apparently, news to me, they have triples in there, but it's not a lot. It's probably like a couple of triples, but they mostly have doubles, which is the traditional, you know, dorm room, two people in a room type thing. Okay, cool. So back to what I was saying about my freshman year. My freshman year, those were the four options available. But of course, the VCU over-admitted students. So GRC 3, which is right behind GRC, y'all share a courtyard. When you walk into GRC, you scan your card, this big door is right there, right in front of your face. You open it, you go to the courtyard, you see the building right there. That is GRC 3. So if you live in GRC 3, you have to walk through GRC to get to your dorm building. So that was an option. I don't think that was not an only freshman dorm, but they had to put freshmen in there because there was no more room. And GRC 3 is apartment style, so you have a kitchen, you have a little living area, y'all have a bathroom, and y'all have a sink in there and whatnot. And I think it's like two people in each like apartment type thing. Also, we have Cabness, which we call Cabby, which is a dorm building on the MCB campus, and that's usually for like nursing students and everything like that, because all the medical majors are most of their classes are on that campus, so it makes sense for their dorm to be there. But like I said, VCU over admitted, so we had to house freshmen in that dorm building. And then we had a campus connector that will bring people from that dorm back to the main campus for their classes and whatnot. And the thing about that dorm, they didn't really have beds. The beds were kind of like a chair, you know, those little couches that they'd be making like beds in some type of apartments. If I could find the picture of what I'm talking about, I'll insert it, but that's how the beds were. I've never been in Cabby, but I've seen snaps of Cabby because I had a friend that stayed there. So yeah, so that was our situation. Fast forward to fall 2019, so by the end of my freshman year, they knocked down Cabby. Like, that summer, they got rid of Cabby, so Cabby was no more. Then that's when they took away the campus connector. They're supposed to be rebuilding Cabby, and when you go down to MCV, they're rebuilding it, or like they're gonna start rebuilding it or whatnot. So Cabby is no longer an option for housing. So fall 2019 had a unique situation where I'm not sure if these options were on the housing application, but they housed freshmen and upperclassmen dorms. Now, freshman housing is supposed to be guaranteed, but it's not really guaranteed. It's guaranteed as long as we have housing. But the good thing for y'all is that y'all are priority. So they're gonna make sure freshmen have housing. They're gonna make sure you have housing. So if they have to kick out upperclassmen out their dorm, they will kick upperclassmen out their dorm to house y'all. Another thing I forgot to say, if you're in the freshman dorms, you must have a meal plan. Like, that's it. If you're a freshman and you get put in the upperclassmen dorm, you don't have to have a meal plan because, duh, there's a kitchen in there. There is a kitchen in GRC. It's on every other floor, but like, that's a community kitchen, so like, is it really that clean? Okay. But yeah, so fall 2019, y'all only had GRC, and at that point GRC became ghetto. That was my sophomore year, right? So GRC is now ghetto. Like I told y'all, GRC was brand new. I was the first class to stay in there because VCU stays over admitting students. They really know what they're doing. They stay over admitting students. GRC, the study rooms in GRC became dorm rooms. Like, we literally did not have housing for y'all. They literally blacked out the windows and put beds in the study rooms. So there's no longer any study rooms in GRC. As people started to transfer or like move out of the dorms because they want to live off campus or whatever throughout the school year, they started moving people into the dorm buildings, into the dorm rooms that have space. But as far as I was told, the study rooms became dorm rooms. Ghetto. Ghetto. Okay. Then they put freshmen in upperclassmen dorms. Like, we have, I think, 6 upperclassmen dorms: West Grace South, West Grace North, Grace and Broad 1 and 2, Ackle, and Broad and Belvedere. 6 upperclassmen dorms. Now, they were putting them in West Grace South, I believe, Grace and Broad, and probably West Grace North. They were putting y'all in there. I don't think there were any freshmen in the other dorm buildings, so they were putting y'all in there. Okay, so if you want to see a tour of that, make sure to YouTube it. I know some people did a tour, it's pretty nice, or y'all can look on the website, all that good stuff. I'm not gonna go into depth about how those dorm buildings are, because most of you are gonna be put in the freshman dorm buildings. So don't even worry about it. Unless it's on your application, let me know. So those freshmen were put into those buildings. Now, the end of my sophomore year, which is now, we were told, I'm a student ambassador for VCU, so I give the tours to prospective students and let them know about VCU. So they told us not to talk about Johnson because guess what? They're knocking Johnson down. Johnson is freaking 17 stories, y'all. Something like that. More than 15. And it had triples. So you know that could house a lot of freshmen because it was 3 people to a room. And y'all knocking it down. Mind you, they already knocked down Cabby. Now they're knocking down Johnson. So Johnson is not even an option for fall 2020, class of 2024. That's not even an option for housing for you guys. It's the oldest dorm on campus. But like, still, now housing is definitely scarce. It's definitely scarce. And they knocked it down. So now you're down 2 dorm buildings. GRC is already ghetto because you're making study rooms dorm rooms. And now you're putting freshmen, upperclassmen dorm buildings, knocking out the upperclassmen who don't have anywhere else to live. So make it make sense. So Johnson is not an option. So fall 2020, y'all got GRC, Brant, and Rhodes. Three dorms. Three. That's all y'all got. And then they probably will put you in GRC 3, West Gray South, all that good stuff. Now the thing is, upperclassmen pick their housing before freshmen even do their housing. Like, we pick our housing in March. So people who are already in upperclassmen housing, they can choose to stay in their same room. Most of them do. So if you come and you're a freshman and you don't get any of the three housings, GRC, Brant, or Rhodes that I mentioned, and they put you in West Gray South or something like that, the roommate that you picked most likely will not be with you. Because if three people in that apartment chose to keep their room and a senior graduated, there's no way you and your roommate that you wanted to be with could be together. You'll be separated. That's just the reality of the situation. So more than likely, you will not be with your roommate. So that's all I gotta say about housing like that. That's how it works. The application opens up. The best way to get the choice that you want is to do it as soon as it opens up. I got GRC, which was my first pick, and application opened up at like 4 p.m. I was on it at 4 p.m., but because everybody was on it, it crashed. So I couldn't even get on it until 5 o'clock, but I still got the dorm that I wanted. So your best bet is to fill it out the first day. Two. Another question I got is about roommates, this, that, and the third. Yes, you choose your roommate as a freshman. You can pick your roommate. Now, your roommate cannot affect the dorm building that you get. If I turn in my application the first day and my roommate turns it in the last day, then that's not gonna make me like get, that's not gonna like not, hold on. Okay, let me get my words together. If I fill out my application on the first day and my roommate fills it out on the last day, it's not going to affect me from getting my first choice. That's what had happened to me. I had filled out my application on the first day, and Precious literally did not fill out her application until like closer to the deadline. So I was like, bro, I'm not going to get GRC because she filled it out late and they're going to pair us together. So instead of me getting GRC, it's going to bump me down to getting my last choice. Because in my head I was thinking, because we're going to be seen as one, like one application kind of, I was thinking that they're going to say like, oh, I turned it in like the day that she turned it in, because she turned it in later. But in reality, what happens is, if you turn in your application early and then you find a roommate and they turn it in like way after you, you pull them in, so you pull them higher. So if I'm out of 10 people and I'm the second to turn in my application and she's the eighth person, she gets pulled up to second with you. So it doesn't affect you not getting the choice that you want. So go ahead. Don't worry if you don't have a roommate. Don't wait till you find a roommate. Turn in your application the first day to get the best choice. Okay? And accept it right away as soon as they send you the email as to what you get. And put your preferences, because some of y'all may not get your first choice. You may get your second. So make sure when you do your preferences, that's the order that you want your housing, because that's the order they're going to give it to you. If you don't get your first choice, you're going to get your second choice type thing. So make sure all your choices that you want, you put it like that. Now, what else? There was something else I was going to mention, but I kind of forgot. Visitation. Oh no, before I go to that. If you're in GRC and you live on campus, you can access any dorm on campus. You can swipe in anywhere. For other dorms, it does not work like that. Your ID only works for that specific dorm. At least when I was in GRC, I can get into any dorm building on campus, but every other dorm building on campus could not get into a dorm that was not theirs. If that makes sense, if you're following me. Visitation. Our visitation is very flexible. I don't know how many guests we're allowed to have. I think we're allowed to have up to three guests signed in under our name in the dorm room. And that is from, honestly, guests can come in any time of the day, to be honest. But I think once it gets to like midnight or so, I don't really know, I don't really remember, but once it gets to like midnight, then you can't sign anyone in. But to be honest, I don't even think that matters. I'm pretty sure our thing is 24 hours. You can sign people in whenever you want, and it's a max of 3 guests, I believe. But make sure that person has a VCU ID, if they go to VCU, of course, and they're not in your dorm building. They have their license or some type of ID, because the desk is going to take that ID and hold on to it. That's how they keep account of who is in the dorm building and under whose name. So remember, whoever you sign in, you're responsible for. If they do something that is under your name, just like my story time when I had signed that boy in and I had gotten in trouble because I had signed him in and what he did coincided with me. Make sure you are aware of who you're signing in and you're responsible. Don't let them be wandering around and everything like that, because some people be acting stupid. And some RAs are really picky and they'll be like, who is that? Because they know everybody on their floor. And if you're not with the person, then you get in trouble. But ain't nobody care about that. That's the least of your worries. So that's how visitation works. Overnight stay. I think the person can stay overnight for up to 48 hours, I think, and then they can only stay overnight up to like 3 separate times, something like that. To be honest, I don't really think VCU cares about all those rules. As long as the person has an ID and you're with them, then it really don't matter. It don't matter. Now, another thing to make, if you want upperclassmen housing after your freshman year, this is how it works. Fill out the housing application. Like, the way, okay, freshman, it was first come, first serve. So if you filled out the application early, then you got your choice. If you filled out late, then you either didn't get your choice or you didn't get anything, type thing. But for upperclassmen, it doesn't matter when you fill it out. As long as you fill it out before the deadline, it doesn't matter, because it's a lottery. That's what I learned. It's a lottery. So it's not first come, first serve anything. If you filled it out the last day, you can get housing, and someone else who filled it out the first day doesn't get housing, which was me. So basically how that works is everybody fills out the application. They pull names, whatever, give you a lottery number. Depending on what number that you are, depends on the time that you pick your housing, and then you go into the portal and pick your housing option. That's how that works. A good thing to secure upperclassmen housing is if you do one of the living learning programs like VCU Aspire, which is in West Grace South, VCU Globe, which is in West Grace North. They're right across the street from each other, literally. And then VCU Lead and VCU Innovate, which is in Grayson Broad 1 and 2. Those are living and learning programs where you have to take like an extra class, do community service, all these other programs. Those people get secured housing because their housing application, when the school's housing application opens up in March, their housing application opens up in February, so they get to pick housing before everybody else. So if everybody does that, all that housing is already secured before everybody else gets to pick. That's why it's kind of like a good thing. And then if you're in the Honors College, everybody gets their own room and bathroom, so you never have to worry about housing because you're staying in the Honors College if you're an honors student or whatever. So yeah, okay y'all, so upperclassmen housing basically works like I said previously, everyone does the housing application, you're in a lottery, and then you have a time slot to pick your housing. When you get your number, you can either make a roommate group, and when you make a roommate group, all of you guys are put together. So when you guys all get your lottery numbers, if someone gets 10, someone gets 1,000, someone gets 200, and someone gets 50, go with the person who has the lowest number. So you will go with the person who has 10, because they're gonna pick earlier, and they will have a better chance of pulling everybody in. That's how the pull-in works. So if the person has 10, and they go in at 12 o'clock to pick housing, everything is going to be open because it just opened and they got to pick before everybody else. So they'll pull you in and then all of you guys get that room. So you don't even have to worry about the time that it told you to pick housing, because you're getting pulled in by someone else who has a lower number than you. That's why it's good to make roommate groups, because if you make a roommate group of 4, then you have 4 chances to get a better chance, a better time at choosing housing than everybody else. Now, usually housing goes by quick, like in the first 15 minutes, it's gone. When housing is gone, they will send out an email saying that there is no more housing. Even if it wasn't your time yet to pick, they'll send out that email. And what you can do is put your name on a list for people, like if they decide that they don't want the room anymore, or they change their mind, or whatever the case may be, the housing is open. If your name is on that list, that will be first come, first serve. So whoever put their name on the list first, they'll send you an email saying that this housing is open, these will be your roommates, and if you want that housing, you can pick that housing. And then once you secure your housing as an upperclassman, if you don't want to live off campus, make sure you know the deadline to keep your same spot. Because I know people who did not know the deadline, they lost their housing spot and they didn't get housing again. It is hard to get housing, so once you secure that spot, keep your same room so you're guaranteed for the rest of your college years that you have housing. Unless you know for a fact that you do not want to live on campus anymore, you got a core, you got a Baines, and you want to live in the suburbs or whatnot. Same room assignment, sis. Same room assignment. And then when you have your same room, if you're already in the upperclassman dorm and you pick your same room, you can make a group and pull your friends into that room with you. That way, they don't even have to worry about their numbers either. So that's the plus. Once you secure upperclassman housing, you can help your friends who did not get housing by pulling them in for the next year and things like that. So I think that's basically everything I want to say. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to comment, like, subscribe, share with your homies, and turn on your post notifications so you know every single time I post, okay? I'm gonna catch y'all in the next video. Beads gang. I know you ain't hot to man. I'm ballin' on the pussy nigga like you want a man. I'm drowning all inside the pussy like I never swam. Hey, fuck your IG, I put something on your sonogram.